Hello and welcome to Channel 48. My name is Buck. Today I got from Hugo his old iPhone 5. The thing is broken. It was still going on. It's a 64 gigabyte. And the screen is broken, as you can see. And in fact, yeah, I thought I still had a 16 gigabyte, so I would just put that screen over to the 64 gigabyte phone. So this is in fact the 16 gigabytes. It's empty at this moment. I replaced the screen and I put it on the 64 gigabyte phone, and there it is. So this iPhone 5 is running iOS 10.3.3. because it's being 64 gigabyte, we can have some fun with it. We could, for instance, jailbreak it, and we could then install Coolboot. And with Coolboot, we will be able to install several iOS versions into this phone. And because it being 64 gigabyte, and because I did not install anything, I will have a whole lot of space that I will be able to use under that new installation. Coolest is, I will be able to downgrade. So yeah, is it necessary to downgrade your iPhone 5? I don't really think so. I think it's running pretty good on that 10.3.3, and I think if you're using it as a daily phone still, then probably you should leave it on 10.3.3. But if you just like me also have, you know, the bigger brother, and the thing is in fact not doing too much, then in fact we could make a special device from it. We could make a device that will do special things, for instance only filming or editing, or, you know, being some music TV player, whatever, in the car, some Navi. And I think it will even be faster on a lower build of iOS, don't you think? So you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna jailbreak this device. So if you also have the iPhone 5, not the S, the S is 64-bit, this is a 32-bit phone. So if you have the iPhone 5 still, and you also have one that is 32 or 64 gigabytes, then probably you can also do this. You will be able to do this. If you're on 10.3.3 as well, then it will be absolutely no problem to jailbreak this phone. What will you need? You will need H3Lix. I think you should pronounce it as Relix. And that is an application that you will have to push with a little tool called Cydia Impactor to the phone. So how does it work? So you have a Windows computer with iTunes installed, and then you get this little IPA file that will be pushed via the Cydia Impactor, that while your phone is connected to the computer. Okay, you need iTunes. iTunes need to be installed on the computer. If you're on a Mac, it will be also really easy to do this. One thing that you should do is go to ID.appleid.apple.com, and up there you should create a special username that you're gonna use for these things. Okay, don't use your standard account, because in some way Apple will not accept it. So just create a new account. I just did, because my old account was not being accepted. And then you can push the file to the phone. So let's do it together. Let's get started. Okay, there we are. You can do this with a Windows computer or a Mac. All right. I saw that even Linux was supported, but I tried. I could not open the Cydia Impactor on the Linux. So I'm going to do this, or I did it with my Mac, but I'm going to show this on a Windows computer, because most of you are using Windows computers. So whenever you open Cydia Impactor, it's going to look like this. And the other file, you already have it on your desktop and you're just gonna pop it in there. In the box that just opened, you're gonna put in an email address that you just created, at least that you use to create your new Apple account. And you're also gonna put in the password. After you did that, the file, the IPA, the H3LX RC3 file will be copied to the phone. Okay, when that is done, it might end up with some error, but you saw it copying, you know, you see the application on the phone. Don't worry about the error. The application is already on the phone. All right. Next, you're gonna click the application and it's gonna say that that user, you know, you are not administrator and you can change this in settings. So what you're then gonna do is you're gonna go to settings. Okay, you're gonna go to settings and then you go to info or to all. How is this called in English? Algemeen. You got it right. This one here. Wherever you're gonna go to info and see about the phone, but don't go to info. Just go down and up here under VPN. You're gonna see apparaat here, system manager. Okay, and then you click it and then you're gonna see the IP or the email address that you used. Okay, and then you're gonna give it permission. Oops. So now you just give that app permission to be an administrator on the phone. Next thing, you're gonna click the application. Whenever you're gonna open it, it will say do you want to jailbreak the phone? Okay, then of course you say yes and then the process will start and the phone will kind of reboot. And then whenever you get back in the desktop of the phone, in the home screen, you're gonna see Cydia. Okay, so then the jailbreak went fine and Cydia is there, and if Cydia is also opening, then you're good to go. Next pop-up that you will get is upgrade. Simply go for essential upgrade. All right, just hit essential upgrade and then the Cydia will be updated in a way that it's good enough to use. Okay, now then Cydia will reboot, and after you get back in Cydia, you're gonna go here at the bottom at sources. Okay, you're gonna hit the sources tab and here on top you're gonna hit change and then add. And in the ad, you're gonna type coolbooter.com. And then you're gonna add that. So then you have coolbooter added, and then you're gonna go to the repo. Just hit the coolbooter that you just installed and to all the packages. And then up here, you can go ahead and install coolbooter. Just, you know, tap it and then on here on top install. So that was kind of easy, yeah? So we jailbroke the phone and we even installed coolbooter. So let's see what we should do now. So coolbooter is a very nice application that will give you the possibility to install different versions of iOS that go along with this phone. So let's hit the install and let's see. Oh, we can go back all the way to, look at that. We can go back all the way to iOS 6. 6.1, 6.13, 6.14. I never knew that this phone got 6.14. And 7, we could go to 7. 7.02. Look at that. We were on 10.3.3, we can go to 10. Look at all these versions that we can go to. I don't feel the need to go to 6.1.3. But I would love to see what the people can still do with 7.12, because the iPhone 4 is, as I think the last iOS version for the iPhone 4 is 7.12. So let's go to 7.12. That will also give us some more possibilities with installing applications. And here we can select how big we want it to be. I want this thing to be huge, yo. I'm gonna give this thing, look at that. Oh, I love the 64 gigabyte phone, yo. Look at that. We're gonna give it, let's give it 32 gigabytes. Okay, let's give it 32. And then we hit storage and then we say, I'm ready. Oh, no, 32. I'm ready, select, and then I'm ready. Would you like to use a custom boot logo? No. Would you like to verbose mode? That's all the text in the screen. No, we just want the Apple. Would you like to jailbreak the other OS? No, I don't want that. I want this to be 50% jailbroken. Would you like to use a protected volume in the other OS? This will require extra 1 gigabyte on the other, this will use another extra gigabyte on the other OS. Answer no if unsure. Data protection workaround. I think it's safer to use a data protection workaround, don't you think?
No, it's a bad idea. Better select no, otherwise you're gonna end up with only 1 gigabyte of space left in your new installation. Okay, so just select no here. Even though I selected yes, I had to learn the hard way and had to do the complete thing again. So I will spare you all that headache. Select no and you're gonna be good to go.
This way, I'm gonna leave it just like that. Let me put it a little bit to the back that it does not fall. And then I'm gonna get back to you whenever this is starting, and then we're gonna see what we should do even more. By the way, if the phone is busy with this process, if Cool Booter is busy, please don't disturb it. Okay, just let it go, because it might not like that. Okay, it might not like that, so just leave it. Don't touch it. Just let it go. And soon we're gonna take a look at the result. Please restart your device. Okay, we did it, my friends. We did it. I'm tre happy. Let me see what's gonna happen. If it's gonna reboot. Please restart your device. Okay, we're rebooting. And now, just imagine somebody found your phone or stole your phone, kicked you down, grabbed your phone because they think the information is on the phone. And he's gonna turn on the phone. Then he must still know the 4-phrase passcode, but that's not so hard to find these days. They have complete machines for that and other ways. These days is very easy. They have the information too.
The coolest thing is as well that you can use that second iOS version to effect safe private files that you don't want others to find whenever they get into your phone. You know, of course you have a 4-phrase pass lock, but most of the times these things are being cracked really fast. I think it's also a nice place to hide certain files if you're working for some big company. You know, USB sticks are being lost all the time, and sometimes people get into your phone and they find these files that, while these are, you know, secret files of the company or whatsoever, you could store them on that second partition and just be on 10.3.3, and no one will ever know that you have a hidden partition with all sorts of secret files on there, files, you know, personal files that you don't want to share.
And now you can see that we are back. So now Cool Booter will not work. So yeah, we must first click the helix again, and then we must kickstart it,
And then we must wait 32 seconds. So special thanks to QRT, QRT Orup GK9357. What kind of name is that? And the jailbreak was with thanks to Timstar and Sigusa. So thank you very much, gentlemen. So now it's it jailbroke itself again. So now we are jailbroken again. So that means after a reboot, you are not jailbroken. You must still run that. And now we can go into coolbooter. And now we can say boot. And now we're gonna boot into 7.12. And now we lock our device. And this should work. Finishing installation, please wait. Aha. Très, très belle. This is very nice. I like. There we go. There we go. It's finishing the installation. Jawel. Look at that thing. And we have a brand new iPhone. Hello. You see that? Dang. I must put in my passcode. So let me do that real fast. No SIM card installed. Let's put it to English. You can see that the first country that it's showing is Germany. So we learn from that, as I learned you in my previous video, that this is a German phone. Hugo got this phone in Germany, or he got it from some German, he bought it. The guy had only Apple, was a teacher. Hugo, Netherlands. So let me connect to Wi-Fi. Oh, this type's so nice. This is no lag, no lag at all. This is amazing. The way the thing types. It's gonna activate the phone. Okay, we are activated. I don't need no location services for now. Set up as a new iPhone. Skip this test. Yes, skip. Agree. Don't send. Get started. There you go. Wow. Look at this. This, I think, no, this is better. This is better for this phone. 7.12. There is not available storage. Oh, you mean? The camera is not working. You see that? The camera is broken. There's something wrong with this camera. I don't know what it is. Really, I don't know. So my Afghani friend must look at that for me. But hey, let's see what we can remove. You see, in the old versions of iOS, you could not remove certain things. But now you can remove a whole lot of things that you don't want. So, this is it. It's very, very, very snappy. We are connected to the Wi-Fi. And we are downgraded to 7.12. So yeah, can we still install WhatsApp? Tja, we only have 1 GB of space left. I have to do the complete thing again. And I know where I went wrong. We had to select no, as I already told you, whenever we were doing the setup of the iOS 7.12. So yeah, let me go do that real fast. I'm not gonna show you that all. We're gonna do the same procedure. I'm only gonna select no, and I'm gonna select to use a big part of the hard drive of the internal for the 7.12. Okay, I was saying, what's up? So I'm on iOS 7. I Yeah, I had to do the thing again. In fact, we should not choose the 1 gigabyte thing whenever we set up the system, because now you're gonna see I have set this thing to have up to 44 gigabytes. So I'm using 44 for this installation, and I installed, instead of 7.12, I installed 7.703. Okay? So, but what I discovered, I created a new account today, special for this phone and for the jailbreak, in fact. And I tried to use that account to download applications, but most of my applications I could not download. Eh? I could not download iMovie, could not download Intro Designer. It was demanding iOS 9, GarageBand, of course, I would never be able to download because I bought that one under this account that I'm using. So I switched back to my own account, and then suddenly I also went and tried to install WhatsApp. And it did not work. It said you need iOS, I don't know how much for WhatsApp. But now I'm back on my old account, and now look what it's saying. Would you like to download the older version? But if you create an account now, so if you're a new user, a new Apple user, then WhatsApp will not work. You won't have no WhatsApp. You will not be able to download the old version. So yeah, me being an Apple user for such a very long time has a whole lot of benefits, because on this account I can download WhatsApp, but another user that would be on iOS 7 with his account, probably he would not be able to download WhatsApp. You see? So that means that WhatsApp still for me works on iOS 7.12. on the iPhone 4. And now I understand why people are telling me, hey, wait a minute, this thing is already installed, go away here. And now I understand why people are telling me, hey, oh, it's not working. Oh my goodness, that is a big shame. What's up? What are you doing? Oh, is it working? What is happening? Let me see. Oh! Cancel. Why is this not working? Maybe because I'm on a... No, that should not be the case. It's not really loading, you see that? The WhatsApp. So I was talking a whole lot. I can download it, but it's not working. Okay, the iPhone X look and feels. How to get them on this device? Well, let me show that to you. I just rebooted the phone, so in fact, Cydia should not work now. As you can see, I will have to... Let me see what I should do. I should have to go to the Helix app again. You see that? And then I will have to kickstart it. So I'm running the exploit. Because yeah, if you're gonna jailbreak the device, it's also nice if you can immediately give it updated look and feels, right? So there we are. Yeah, the home button of this thing is a little bit... I really miss my slider. I hate the home button. I think, you know, the home button is the case that these phones, every time these home buttons, they at a certain moment break, because people must press them too much, too often. Okay, so let's go into Cydia. And after you did the essential upgrade, in fact, you should already be good to go. You go to the search, let this load. Sorry, close this surface, so this thing will give an error. But only thing that you need to type is iPhone and then X. And there you're gonna find it, iPhone XTEAM. Install it, okay? It will also install Anemone. And Anemone is, in fact, the application. It's a sort of winter board. And it will help you to get this look and feels. And you will be able to select certain parts in Anemone. I enabled it already. I don't want to go and mess it up. But in fact, if you're gonna preview, then you're gonna see whatever you're gonna get before you're gonna create it. You see? And in fact, the notch, then you just hit apply. The notch that you see there, effect is, that is a little secret that I'm gonna make a little video about, because this notch you can get as well on not jailbroken devices. Let me show you how it looks in the lock screen. You see that? And this is an iPhone 5, guys. This is just the iPhone 5 32-bit. The 5S is 64-bit. So, the notch thing, that is for a special video. And then I'm gonna show that probably in the video after this one. I'm gonna show you how to get the notch on any device, jailbroken or not. You know, iPhone 4, 5, 6, 7. All these phones that have no notch, you will be able to give a little notch. Okay? And because I have no SIM card installed, it's looking kinda ugly at this moment. So what I'm gonna do is set it to airplane mode, and this is how it then should look. You see that? We even got a sort of bit round corners at the top. So yeah, it makes the device look very, very lovely. It's still a very nice phone. Tja, and that for 15 euros. I say thank you so much, Brother Hugo. And even though I got it with a cracked screen, and even though the cams are not working anymore, don't know what that is, I can still make phone calls. I just tested that. The SIM part works fine. Home button, yeah, but that has to do with my effect with the screen that I put from my other phone. So this problem was already with my iPhone 5 that I had. The screen was completely broken, so I replaced the screen. It was very easy. Just two little screws, and then, you know, lift up the screen, loosen up three other screws there, and yeah, loosen up these connections and put in the other screen. It was 10 minutes work, not worth it to film. And now we have this. Very nice, lovely, and it works very good. So yeah, that's it. Let's go back to the studio.
So yeah, go play with your old iPhone 5 or 4S. Remember, these devices must be 32-bit. You can also do this with the iPad. Okay, if you still have an iPad 2, just like me, mine is running 8.2, but I also installed 9.3. I think the last version that these iPads can get. So I can then see, you know, how 9.3 is kind of functioning on the device. But I can assure you that 8.2 runs even better. And the feelings of this phone, the way it feels, the way it's kind of reacting, is very, very snappy. It's very, I think the phone actually got faster by this downgrade from 3.3 all the way back to 7.04. Hey guys, girls, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching, and see you in the next video again. Hasta la vista.